Coming up on Cooking Crave, we have a couple new cookie recipes that we're going to pair with a chai tea that your family's sure to love. Stay tuned. Hi, I'm Rhonda Fitterer.
And I'm Laverne Didi.
And we have a couple submitted cookie recipes, one from our good neighbor, Sharon.
Yes.
She always gives us the best recipes.
We have had some really good ones.
So I can't wait to taste this cookie recipe. And then a relative of our cameraman, we have one from Sherry and Toral Sanford too, a crinkle top cookie.
I think these cookies are going to be added to one of your favorites, and you're going to put it on the top of your recipe book.
Awesome, awesome. And then you found a chai tea to go with that.
Well, and actually it's submitted.
So, yeah. Oh, actually, yes. So we have three submitted recipes today. That's awesome. And so one of these ladies here is in the running for the aprons that we give out every month.
That
you,
will be nice.
You use your recipe on air, your name goes in the drawing for a free apron, so perfect.
Okay.
So if you want to go ahead and cook along with us today, just grab a piece of paper and a pen and write down these ingredients. We have a cornflake cookie, and that was submitted by Sharon. For this recipe, you're going to need a cup of butter, a cup of sugar, a teaspoon of vanilla, 1 1/2 cup of flour, 1/2 teaspoon each of baking soda and cream of tartar, and 2 cups of cornflakes.
Pretty simple.
That is pretty simple. Okay. So make sure you get that one down. And then this one is the crinkle top cookies from Sherry and Toral Sanford. You're going to need 3/4 cup shortening, 1 cup of sugar, 1 egg, 1/4 cup of molasses, 2 teaspoons baking soda, 2 cups of flour, and then 1 teaspoon each of ginger and cinnamon.
Not too difficult either, is it?
No, okay. No. It's always better when mom cooks them for you, too. And for the chai tea, this was submitted by Jerry Zeller of Mott. Thank you, Jerry, for doing that. You're going to need 1 cup of non-fat dry milk, 1 cup of powdered non-dairy creamer, 1 cup of French vanilla flavored powdered non-dairy creamer. Woofty. That's a mouthful. 2 1/2 cups of sugar, 1 1/2 cups of unsweetened instant tea, 2 teaspoons ground ginger, 2 teaspoons of ground cinnamon, 1 teaspoon each of ground cloves and ground cardamom, if I said that correctly. And you're just going to mix that up, but we'll get into that when we get to the tea. But those are the ingredients you need for the tea.
Right.
All right. Okay. Well, where do you want to get started today?
Well, I would like to mix up the tea first. Okay. And that, so that's pretty simple. Like I said, it was 1 cup of instant powdered milk.
Okay.
And then we want 1 cup of French vanilla creamer. So we're going to just measure that in here.
Okay.
There we go. And then 1 cup of regular creamer.
So this is going to make actually quite a bit that you're going to be able to use for quite a while.
Right. You're going to just store it in an airtight canister, container, whatever. And, you know, it depends on how much you drink, how long it's going to last.
Yeah.
But it's going to go quite a ways for you, Steph. So. And then 1 1/2 cups instant tea.
Okay.
So rather than trying to have all these bowls out with that measure, I figure this isn't going to take very long to put all these things in a measuring cup. There, that's 1 1/2 cups of just instant tea. And we're going to mix all these things together, and then we're actually going to put it in our blender just to, you know, make it finer.
Okay.
And that too. So it's 2 1/2 cups of sugar.
Okay. Yeah, with the tea and the sugar, you got bigger granules than you do with the powders. So.
That's right. And it's going to mix up there. So it's 2 teaspoons ginger. And 2 teaspoons of cinnamon.
Okay.
For these cold winters, I think we're just going to really enjoy having, you know, a nice drink like this. And then it's just 1 teaspoon of cloves. The others were 2. Now, the difference is it asks for 1 teaspoon of cardamom.
Okay.
Cardamom is a very expensive spice, and it's a spice you don't probably going to use a lot.
Okay.
In fact, when I Googled it, I says, what would be a good substitute for cardamom?
Okay.
And they said a good substitute is actually cinnamon and cloves were the two, was the top one. And so if you need a teaspoon of cardamom, you use a half a teaspoon of cinnamon and a half a teaspoon of cloves.
Okay.
And that, and they said that the cardamom is the third highest or third most expensive spice.
Oh.
So, you know, if it's not something you're going to use a lot, just substitute.
Okay.
And that's what I'm doing.
Okay.
Because, you know, that was something I actually did not have in my cupboard was cardamom.
Okay.
I don't think, apparently I've never had a recipe that needs it. So I'm going to add just another half a teaspoon of cloves and another half a teaspoon of cinnamon to get that teaspoon of cardamom that we don't have. So.
Okay.
Like I said, you know, I have found usually if I don't have the spice in my cupboard, most people aren't probably going to. So.
Right.
I put it in a bowl that does have a lid. So what's going to be the easiest is for me is just to mix it like this and to get it mixed well. And then we're going to put it in my blender here.
Okay.
And it does definitely, you can see that, like you said, the different...
yeah, but with the powdered milk being probably the the most coarse in there.
Right. Okay. So let's just take that off there. And I think I will just take my whisk and just
see a little bit more. Don't go too crazy, though.
Yeah, not too crazy. I've certainly done that. And you don't want to fill up your blender with, you know, to the top. You want to do maybe a cup or two at a time.
Okay.
And just blend that well. And then we will pour that, set that aside, and then we will make our cookies, and then we're going to sit down and have some tea and cookies.
They're perfect.
Doesn't that sound like a good thing on a cold winter day?
Absolutely.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is just take a cup of this. You know, she said, you know, from a 1 to 2 cups in there and that. So we're going to put that in there and turn that on and just blend that. Okay, we have that last blender mix here. And as we pour this in, you can really definitely see how much finer that is.
Absolutely.
And that if you just took that for a, you know, without putting it in the blender.
Sure.
So we got quite a bit to the side here too. So we're going to take all those dry ingredients out. And then you're going to, this here, you just put like 2 heaping tablespoons and like 8 to 10 ounces of, or a coffee cup of hot water.
Sure.
Or to taste, you know, if you like it stronger. That's what you do, and if not, you just make it to taste. But like I said, you know, as our viewers can see how it's pretty much a powder.
Yes.
And that, so.
Well, and you know, just how much was in that big bowl, this is what it came down to. It did really condense down.
So that's one thing for you to remember when you do put it in your hot water, probably start with a heaping tablespoon and go from there, because being that it is condensed down so much more than if you would have just used it as without, you know, condensing it down, makes a big difference. So we're going to set that aside. And we're going to get this out of the way. And we're going to then start with our cookies.
All right.
And I'm going to start with the cornflake ones for the fact that it's a lighter, creamier. The other one, it's got molasses in it, so I don't have to wash the bowl. You know, you do this one in there. So you start with the lighter cookie. So we'll bring that over here. And plug in our mixer. And we're going to just bring this over here. And we're going to start with, you definitely want to use butter for this one.
Okay.
This cookie reminds me a lot of the pecan sandies. Even though there's nuts, there isn't nuts in here with the cornflakes and that, it has that
crunch,
you know, to it, texture, and just really, really good. So We'll put that in there. And you know what? You want to have your butter out at room temperature.
Okay. Don't need it cold or...
No, you don't want it cold. You just want it, you know, soft.
Okay.
So we're going to... And then we're going to cream that together just with our sugar and a teaspoon of vanilla.
Okay.
Okay, there we go. And we'll put the cup of sugar in there. And we'll do the teaspoon of vanilla. Got my teaspoon here. And I'm just using the powdered vanilla. I really do like this, but you know, your other vanilla does always work fine too.
Okay.
And that, but I do really find that this has a little stronger taste or vanilla flavor to it. It's like a real true extract. So we want to beat this until it's a little light and fluffy.
Okay.
So that will take a few moments, and then we add the
rest of the ingredients.
Flour and cream of tartar and a little bit of baking soda and the cornflakes, and that's done. It's so simple. You know, when you think about it, there isn't any other wet ingredients
right
in this, and the first time making it I thought, oh, not even an egg, but they were awesome.
Okay. All right.
Country Rose Cafe on East Villard is open for breakfast and lunch 7 days a week. Enjoy daily homemade specials, caramel and cinnamon rolls, several different kinds of homemade pies made fresh every day. Country Rose Cafe is also famous for homemade soup, including their ever-popular Nefla served every Tuesday. While you're in, make sure to pick up your Channel 18 Cooking Crave recipes and like us on Facebook for different specials and announcements. Country Rose Cafe, the way a cafe should be, located at 837 East Villard in Dickens.
Okay, our butter and sugar has really creamed. It's nice and fluffy here, so that's great. We're going to put in the 1.5 cups of flour.
Okay.
It is not a real big recipe, you know, there, but you still get about three dozen of cookies at least out of that. So now we're going to add 1/2 teaspoon of cream of tartar.
In most cookie recipes, you can double or triple if you did want to make big batches.
Oh, very much so. Very seldom do I ever just make one like this. It would, with that, I would be doubling it. But then they are so good, you probably even want to triple it. So, see.
Share it with your friends and family.
That's right. Okay, so we're going to blend that butter and flour together. And then we'll fold in the cornflakes. And it's 2.5 cups of cornflakes. And I did kind of crush them a little bit. I'm not putting in big flakes and stuff. So like I said, it's a very buttery, great cookie. So we'll just mix that up a little bit more here. Okay, now we'll take that off. And we'll just clean off the beater here.
And it's a very crumbly cookie. It looks like a mixture. It's not.
It really won't be until I get all this mixed well. It's, you know, got a nice consistency. It's easy to work with to make, you know, handle it with little balls. But it's not real crumbly.
Okay.
Put it that way. And stuff. So this is the mixed spatula I want here. And see, you know, we're looking at that dough. It's got
it's
a nice...
It's soft.
It is. So just get that all down, and we'll just stir in our cornflakes. And it's really kind of interesting that, you know, the cornflakes almost gives it that nutty flavor without having nuts in there for those that may not... are allergic to nuts or don't like them. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to just scrape this off and just use my hand to work that in a little bit better. It's easier than with a spoon or just that. So, and then we're going to just put it in another bowl there, bowl there. And we're going to go ahead and mix up our cookie crinkles.
Okay.
Whatever that, right away, so. Okay, just getting all that, just about all blended in there. And then you just take, you know, a little teaspoon or make little balls and put them on your cookie sheet. So we'll just put that in there. So you can see that we got the cornflakes all mixed in there. So it's going to be easy dough just to take and make a ball and just put it on your cookie sheet.
Okay.
There we go. Set that one aside, and I'll rinse my hands off, and then we'll get started with the other one. Okay. And that one there, and this one here, again, is a very, very simple, easy recipe to work with. I'll just clean off the spatula a little bit there, and put that in this bowl. Okay, so we're going to start with 1 cup sugar.
Okay.
And let's just look at that sugar here. There we go. And 3/4 cup of shortening, which I do have, which is right over here. Here, and we'll set that bowl aside there.
Okay.
And then we're going to cream that together. And then we'll add our egg. We'll first cream the shortening and
can you substitute butter for shortening?
You know, I'm sure you can. And most often, I do use butter for most everything, but I'm making it the way the recipe says, but I am using the butter Crisco, and okay. I don't think it's going to make a difference either way.
Okay.
So, absolutely, you know, I think the butter would be just fine, too. So, let's get that mixed cream together before we add the egg and the molasses.
Okay.
Well, that mixer keeps going and going. Got that in 87. Oh, it's still going too, so you hear those shots, huh?
Yeah. Well.
Or Trace, whoever's going to do it.
Ron.
Oh.
He has to let me edit it.
Oh, I see.
Okay. Just let me know when you're about ready.
Yeah, I'm going to just stir that down, and then we will be ready. Okay, I'll just put that on there. Okay, we've got the shortening and the sugar cream together.
Okay.
So we're going to add our molasses, and that's just 1/4 cup. Okay, and then we're going to add our egg, and I'm going to just crack that egg right into this bowl here. There we go. And then we'll just mix this up before we add the flour and the soda in that. So,
okay.
Okay, so that one is going to take 2 cups of flour. So I'm going to put that aside there. And did I not measure that out yet? I did not, did I?
Okay. Nope.
Okay. So I just want to scrape this down a little bit more. Okay, now we're going to add 2 cups of flour. And then there are some spices too that we are going to add.
Okay.
And we'll just set that flour aside a little bit. We might end up using a little bit more flour, I'm not sure, because the egg I had was a pretty large egg. So we need ginger and cinnamon here. And so we got that here, and it's a 2 teaspoon of each. And it's 2 teaspoons also of baking soda.
Okay.
So I'll set the cream of tartar aside so I don't grab that one by mistake. So, and I need the teaspoon here. And then these here, we're going to just shape into balls and dip the top into sugar and put it in the on the cookie sheet. We don't flatten them or anything like that.
Okay.
It's going to, and they make that really nice crinkle top.
Thus the name of the cookie.
That's right. It's a good name, isn't it? So there we got, and that was the ginger. So we got everything in there that we need it, so we'll just slowly put that on and blend that up. That doesn't have to mix, you know, any certain length of time, just like, you know, any cookie, you're just getting all that blended in. And
okay, so there. Are both of these being baked at the same temperature?
They're both at 350 and for about that 9 to 10 minutes.
Okay,
so that's what we're going to put that at. So
it kind of smells like a ginger snap almost.
With your molasses in there, correct. It is, so we'll get that. And the consistency feels really about right in there. You know, I was concerned maybe I might have to add a little bit more flour, but I think this is just perfect.
Okay.
So we get that cleaned off there. And what I'll have you do, we're going to... being there both at 350 and almost the same length of time, which we can check. We'll just spray our cookie sheets real lightly because we have some nonstick cookie sheets there. So
okay.
And we'll get a couple of spoons. And what I'll have you do, Rhonda, is I'm going to have you do, I'll put this, here, pull this out so we have a little more space.
Okay.
Make just a teaspoon size with those cookies and just roll them in a ball and then just dip them in there. And I'm going to just do the same for...
Now roll them or just dip them?
Just dip them. Yeah, that's all it says. So that's what we're going to do. And that's so you can see exactly what we're doing. And as soon as the viewers got a good idea what we're, just that teaspoon there. And so then we will be back when we got them all done and pop them in the oven.
Sounds good.
Well, we got our cookie sheets full here. So I am going to just press these down just a little bit, but we don't need to press those down. So we're okay. Gonna pop them in the oven. And this is at 350. And we're going to go ahead and put that at 10 minutes, and then we will check them and we'll be back.
Sounds great.
See your VA home loan expert at ENG Lending of Dickinson. Jay Wandler and the professional staff at ENG Lending provide expertise and services that are traditionally offered by the largest financial institutions, all with the local integrity of a local community bank. No wonder why ENG Lending is the area's number one choice for North Dakota veteran home loans. Visit them online at 456loan.com or call 701-250-8166 today.
Well, we have our buzzer going off here with our cookies. Our crinkle top cookies we took out already because those were done. I added a couple of more minutes with the cornflakes cookies. So
okay.
I'm going to just set that down here. And we're going to just take these out here, and they had a chance to, but they're just, it was exactly 10 minutes.
Okay.
With that. The recipe says right at that 9-10 minutes. So that's just perfect. And We can certainly see why they call them the crinkle top, don't they?
Yes.
With that. Makes them look really, really pretty. So maybe not as pretty as delicious.
They will taste very good. They smell wonderful.
And this way, this cookie here, I went 12 minutes.
Okay.
And so we can just see that it's browned under the bottom. So we're going to just
They don't brown that much on the top, though.
No, you're not going to see that it looks as brown there because everything, it's a very light batter. There's nothing, you know, to that, so. Okay, we'll set this to a side here.
Okay.
And now we're going to try our chai tea with that.
Okay.
I boiled some water here. So it is pretty hot. And a couple there.
Grandkids might just need a little ice cube.
Yeah, with that water, probably. I splashed a little bit of water on my doily. Now, like we said, it said 2 heaping tablespoons. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to use 2 heaping teaspoons for this right away. We're going to try that.
Okay.
And see how that is. And like I said, you know, you're going to make that to your liking. So you can always add more.
But absolutely.
You can't. But you can always add more hot water and then you have more tea if it's too strong, right?
There's but, always a way around it.
Yeah. But as you see, you know, that spoonful is really quite heaping. So I'll have you put some molasses cookies on here.
Okay.
And I'm going to put my... cornflakes here. And like I said, they're just really crunchy too and buttery tasting. So, okay. Well, you know, if you can't fit them all on, they're going to have to eat that one.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. All right. So this and our cookies. This looks like a good tea party to me.
It does. And this would be something that the grandkids, your children would like helping you make, yeah, because none of this was hard.
It wasn't. You know, and the sooner you get them into baking or cooking, the more I think that they will like it and do as they grow up.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I'd like to thank everyone who submitted recipes, because these all 3 recipes today were submitted. Thank you so much. And to you, our viewers, that would like to submit your recipes for Laverne to cook for you on the show, just go to www.ctctel.com. As always, thank you to our sponsor, and join us next time when we do it all over again.